We know this pandemic has been devastating. It's devastating vast swaths of the economy. But what about businesses that are truly essential, like the food chain? Take AGCO, the big maker of farm equipment. Here's a company that was having a tough time before COVID-19 took the world by storm. And then last week, they had to withdraw their full-year guidance. They weren't alone. Believe me, it's impossible to forecast when you don't know how long this outbreak will be with us. Nevertheless, AGCO is bending over backward to get farmers the machinery they need without putting its workforce in danger. Make no mistake, this is an essential business. So let's check in with Martin Richenhagen. He's the chairman, president, and CEO of AGCO to get a better sense of how this company's handling this unprecedented disruption. Mr. Richenhagen, welcome back to Mad Money.
Good evening, Jim. Great to talk to you.
All right. Now, Martin, you are probably the most international of our guests because you've got business in the U.S., Germany, France, United Kingdom, Canada, Brazil, Sweden, Italy. I know you do business in Russia. You do business everywhere. COVID has just destroyed the world's economy. Is there a hope that it can come back?
Well, it's, let's say, the times are tough, and I would like to use an example. It's more difficult, of course, to sail a ship in rough seas, but we have a rock-solid ship, we have a super-motivated crew, and we have a solid captain, and on top of that, my COO, is the second in command, is really leading the direction, and we are doing the right things. So when it comes to your question how we are doing globally, it depends. Here in the US, we work with all factories at capacity, no big impact yet. In Europe, depending on the various legislation and rules, we had to close down certain factories in Germany, Italy, and so on. They're on short time, but we usually do have a summer vacation where the factory is closed, and so we think we can catch up then in during this time. In Brazil, we are very good in coordinating between our industry, not only us, also our peers and the suppliers, in order to get the supply chain in order. And so in China, we are back back working in the factories. So that means overall, I'm slightly optimistic that we will prove that we are a rock solid company. And as soon as the window opens again, I will buy AGCO shares.
You will buy just in the open market?
Yes.
All right. Now, let's go back to Brazil. In the conference call, you weren't that happy with Brazil. You felt, and some of the analysts felt, that you did not necessarily have the right machines. But has that changed? Because you had that beautiful machine here. And I thought that that would have been a big seller in Brazil because they like gigantic machines.
Yeah, we didn't, but the big machines were not our problem. The small machines were our problem. We decided to come in with a new generation of improved, higher technology, small tractors. But the market wanted to have the old-fashioned but cheap standard tractors as well. And so it was an easy fix because we brought those tractors back and we are now selling them again. And market share is coming back as well.
All right, so let's go back to China. I need a little hope here. You're seeing China go back to normal because a lot of people are saying, Jim, don't be fooled. They're not going out at night. Don't be fooled. They can't have crowds. Hey, listen, I just want people to be healthy. I mean, you got people buying equipment?
Well, actually, the difference between us and other industries is we are critical. So we are part of feeding the world, which is also our vision, high-tech solutions for farmers feeding the world. And farms still work and operate. So they need equipment, and that's different from airlines or other equipment which is just not used. Our equipment is used. We need to service the equipment. We need to deliver parts. And the advantage of our digitalization and our advanced technologies is we can do remote monitoring, we do remote service. So that means we are in a position to support our product also in these tough times.
Okay, now I've read through the $2.2 trillion stimulus package. It's got some good news for farmers. I have always felt that when farmers get money, they want to buy new equipment that makes them more efficient. I have to believe that the return on investment on a brand new AGCO tractor is such that they should take advantage of the money they're getting and buy one.
That's what they're doing. They basically buy a pickup truck first and then the tractor. So that means we think they will invest, because also the American farmers suffered a lot before from the sanctions from China. And so the complete package now, with the Chinese most probably buying again and buying more in the future, and subsidies, I think I'm slightly optimistic that we see a better market here in the United States and Canada.
All right, let me just say, let's think a little bit further than just COVID. We had Beyond Meat on, Ethan Brown, terrific guy. We just interviewed the CEO of Conagra. They've got plant-based stuff. I know there's some other companies all working plant-based. Plant-based is big. Doesn't that play into AGCO's sweet spot versus, say, cows?
Yeah, we are much stronger, of course, or we're very strong in the big professional arable farms. Certainly here in the United States, and therefore this industry, this segment is important to us. But we are also decent. We have very great products. We have the world-leading baler coming here from the United States, the Massey Ferguson Heston baler. So that means we have also very attractive product for the dairy farms.
Excellent. Well, look, Martin, it's always great to see you and be with someone who's got a good secular trend regardless of COVID. That's Martin Richenhagen, the chairman, president, CEO of AGCO, who, by the way, let's not bury the lead, said that when he can buy stock, he will do so. Mad Money's back after the break.
Don't miss a second of Mad Money. Follow at Jim Cramer on Twitter. Have a question? Tweet Cramer. Hashtag Mad Tweets. Send Jim an email to madmoney@cnbc.com or give us a call at 1-800-743-CNBC. Miss something? Head to madmoney.cnbc.com.